A great goaltender, a great teammate. He was just one of the gang. That's the way John was.
Johnny Bower, a workhorse. He came in to play, and no matter if it was at practice or wherever, you could depend on Johnny Bower.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are the three stars of tonight's game as selected by Foster Hewitt. The first star, Johnny Bower.
His is the story of a man and a dream and a steadfast refusal to quit on it, no matter how long it took. A story of perseverance and dedication, of literally getting better with age.
Johnny Bower, Johnny come lately to the National Hockey League scene.
John Kiskan, which was his birth name, grew up in Prince Albert, Saskatchewan, a child of the Great Depression.
On course in Prince Albert, he used to get 45 below zero. And us kids would be out there playing hockey in the rivers and ponds and everything and things like that, eh?
He would listen to games on the radio on Saturday nights.
Hello, Canada and hockey fans in the United States and Newfoundland.
And his hero was Boston Bruins goalie Frank Brimzek, because he was known as Mr. Zero. Johnny never saw him play, but he knew he wanted to be just like him. And so the dream was born. The legend of Bower and his age started early, when a 15-year-old lied about how old he was to enlist in the military. It worked. After 4 years, he was discharged and returned to Prince Albert, where age once again came into play. This time, he produced a birth certificate to prove he was younger than everyone thought and was allowed to play junior hockey.
There was a scout there from Saskatoon, Hub Wilson. He scouted for the American Hockey League, and finally he came over and he says, "Do you like to try out with the Cleveland Bears in the American Hockey League?" And I says, "Wow, I don't know. I got a good job. I don't want to leave it." I says, "But anyway, I went down there and I made the grade, and I was a sub goalie there for a little while, and then the regular goaltender there, he retired, so I was in there for good for 8 years."
While in Cleveland, he changed his name to Bower, his mother's maiden name. He said he wanted to make it easier for the sports writers to remember his name.
I had a lot of good years in the American League, and actually right now they tell me I'm playing a lot better than I have been, probably maybe because I'm acquiring more experience in that.
In 1953, he finally made it to the NHL with the New York Rangers. He played 70 games that season, and that's when veteran goaltender Charlie Rayner told Bower he needed to become a better puck handler and he needed to perfect the poke check. It became his trademark. Following that first season, the Rangers decided to give a young Gump Worsley another chance. And over the next 4 seasons, Bower spent all but 7 games back in the minors.
There was times there that I was down a little bit, but good old Nancy, she got a hold of me and she said, "You got to think positive. You can't think negative at all because you can't make it." And then from Cleveland, I went to Toronto in 58-59. So I was very, very fortunate, like, to get on.
Incredibly, Bower was 33 when that first season in Toronto began. A month into it, Punch Imlach took over as coach. He loved his aging goaltender, however old he really was. And Bower flourished under demanding Imlach, calling him the best coach for whom he ever played. Ironically, Bower almost quit in 1961 after a run-in with Imlach, but his captain, friend, and road roommate George Armstrong convinced him to stay.
"John, it took you 16 long years to get into this All-Star game. How do you feel about it?"
"Well, Frank, I certainly feel wonderful about it. It's really a great honor for me to be playing with all these wonderful fellows."
Going down over the blue line. Trying to cut in front. He does. Right in on goal. Bower made the save.
He won 33 games in the Vezina Trophy that season. And while the Leafs lost in the playoffs, it was the start of a Leafs dynasty, and Bower would be a huge part of it.
"For the first time in 11 years, a Toronto team has won the Stanley Cup."
The first of 3 consecutive Stanley Cups arrived in 1962, the Leafs defeating the Chicago Blackhawks. The next spring, Bower and the Leafs beat Gordie Howe and the Red Wings.
"Toronto Maple Leafs have won the Stanley Cup." Cup.
A true measure of the respect Bauer earned was seen minutes after the Leafs had won that cup. While Bauer was being interviewed on the ice, Howe stood with his arm wrapped around his shoulder. Simply unheard of, then and now.
First of all, I'd like to say we certainly played a wonderful game. It could have gone either way, and
with your help.
True friends is how Howe would later describe their relationship.
Well, now you two fellas, your friendship, when did you first get to know each other, John?
Well, I think I met Gordy.
Don't age yourself, John.
Quite about, oh, I'd say 10, 12 years ago, way out west, on a fishing trip, I think.
And the Maple Leafs.
The Leafs would beat the Red Wings in 7 games the following spring and would add an unexpected 4th Stanley Cup in 1967. The over-the-hill gang overcoming long odds to defeat the Canadiens in 6 games.
The Toronto Maple Leafs have won the Stanley Cup.
What a tremendous hockey game this was.
In 1969, he hurt his knee and decided to retire at the age of 45, the oldest goalie to ever play, the first player to have qualified for his pension while he was still playing. He was inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 1976. For some of a certain vintage, they had memories of Bauer between the pipes and the glory years. For others, he was a reminder of a past they didn't see, an always humble and friendly face, who was once described as being the grandfather of the franchise. And so his number was retired, his image bronzed on Legends Row. He may have been the most beloved Leaf, the most recognizable ever. Bauer was as gentle and kind off the ice as he was fearless and relentless on it. A great goalie, a better person.
He's an icon in this city and with the Maple Leafs.
He was one of those guys, kind of old school. He never liked to have a puck in his net, even in practice. You know, the guys would keep shooting behind him, but he'd keep taking them out.
Probably one of the best examples of how to be as a post player is Johnny Bauer. He's the last guy to win a Stanley Cup, win the major trophies, and there's not a fan or a player that has anything bad to say about Johnny.
But I do want to say I'm certainly glad they won the Stanley Cup again for the city of Toronto. I certainly feel that they deserve it. They're wonderful fans, and I hope we can do it again next year. Thank you very much.
Thank you, John.